To say they have heaviness in B in the lower body because there is fire, we don't get to say that unless the yin is all piled up from the waist below and there's no yang in the yin. Remember, it is the yang within yin that raises the yin. It is the yin within yang that lowers the yang. It's not in this program, but when we do the tangible acupuncture for internal diseases, one of the major things we talk about is, why do the yang channels go from heaven to earth, top to bottom? Why do the yin channels go from earth to heaven, the opposite of their direction? Yin goes down. Why do all the yin channels go up? Yang goes up. Why do all the yang channels go down? And a brief synopsis of what we talk about in depth when acupuncture is the critical treatment method is, it is the weight of yin within yang that pulls the yang downwards, and that's why the yang channels often suffer and upwards. And it is the yang within yin that raises the yin up, and without that yang, the yin naturally follows down, which is why we suffer from yin illnesses that go downward. So it is critical to understand that should they separate, you can diagnose depending on what they come in with. This person certainly has yang heat signs above. Certainly, they have to. But that's not what they're showing as their dominant symptom. That's not the symptom that we're looking at and going, oh my goodness. The symptom we're seeing dominant is yin piled below with no life in it, no yang in it. So it's heavy. Yang is movement. Yang is light. And it's B. There's no movement. Yang is movement. Yang is the strength of movement. And so we see a separation, and the dominant symptom isn't bleeding in the nose, isn't any of those things. It's the yin showing up.